The Bodele Depression is located in Chad, which is a country within Africa. That's great. That's a pretty big continent. Well, it's just the south of Libya. Let's zoom in on that. All right, great. We have the Mediterranean Ocean, Libya, and just to the south of there we have Chad. Let's move this globe a little bit to where we can see Chad. Ah, there we go. Highlighting the topography within Chad, we have the Tibetsi Mountains off to the north and the Enedei Mountains off to the east. Notice the concave U-shaped topography that this mountain chain makes up. In between the two, we can explain the funneling that exists into the plains. Highlighted here is the Bodele Depression, which is the outer extension of the ancient Lake Chad. And encircled here, we have the current Lake Chad, encompassing about 5% of its former self. Here on the small depiction, we can see the Marhattan winds, or northeasterly winds, persistent in northern Chad. We have the Tibetsi Mountains highlighted here, and the Enedei Mountains highlighted here. We can see the funneling of winds in between the two, going to the south-southwest. Also, to the north, we can see the setup of the Libyan High. It will have more of a effect on the Bodele Jet. So what we have left is dried lake bed of silts and erodible sediment, which have since dried into fine mineral dust. We can see the direction and the altitude lifting of these particles throughout the year. It's estimated that over half of the mineral aerosol dust from the Sahara Desert originates from the Bodele Depression. And this adds 700,000 tons of mineral dust annually to the Amazon forest. And that's according to a 2006 study by Alan Corin on the Bodele Depression. Here's the TOMS AI, which is the Total Ozone Mapping Spectrometer Aerosol Index, highlighting how much aerosol dust is lifted per year from the Bodele Depression. Again, we have the topography, highlighted dust, Lake Chad, and the natural wind tunnel. The resulting delay in frictional decoupling means a shorter period of time for the low-level jet to develop until sunrise, and therefore ultimately causes a weaker jet maximum. Consequently, the inversion only reaches up to approximately 200 meters, as opposed to 300 meters to 660 meters in the North American Midwest, which initiates and develops differently. Turbulent mixing during the morning hours allows for higher wind speeds to reach the surface with a shallow inversion break. This means that the typical time frame for inversion break is in between 9 and 11 local. The wind tunneling between the topography of the two mountain chains keeps the low-level jet enhanced during the early morning hours, but then subsequently subsides as the high to the north is diminished. Typically, winds in this area only reach 20 to 30 knots, but with the fine aerosols, it really only takes about 10 knots to lift these particles up to a high enough level to decrease visibility in the area. Here we can see the observations for the Faya Largeau or Airport, which is the airport within the natural wind tunnel of the area. We can see the increased winds during the local time frame, or Zulu, according to the ops, and therefore have a better fidelity of the time that this would occur. So things to look out for would be the enhancement of the Libyan High, increasing the northeasterly winds, which tunnel in between the Tibetsi Mountains and Enedei Mountains. It's also important to note that there are no SKUTs or multiple observation locations throughout this area. I hope this has been informational for you. And for any more information within the Bodele low-level jet or the Marhattan winds in general, ask your shift supervisor or SDO.